वेलकम बैक चिल्ड्रन टू दी लेसन रेस्पिरेशन इन ऑर्गेनिजम्स राइट सो हियर इन रेस्पिरेशन इन ऑर्गेनिजम्स वी ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड अबाउट द व्हाट यू कॉल फिश राइट इन रेस्पिरेशन ऑफ एनिमल्स वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फिश एंड सम बिग फिशेस लाइक डॉल्फिन्स और ब्लू व्हेल्स दे हैव ए नॉजल होल एंड इट इज गोइंग टू breathe with the help of this nozzle hole that is present back of the fish and they don't have gills blue whales and dolphins that's why they always comes out of the water and it jumps dives in because they don't have gills right so here like this the fish is going to dolphin is going to breathe and for example here dolphins and as well as blue whales they have lungs crocodile also respire with the lungs right now come to another animal that is frog let us discuss about frog so already we discussed the frog can able to respire through the skin through the gills and as well as through the lungs sorry frog is completed And next one, come to cockroach. Next, come to cockroach. Now, it is cockroach, right? So, cockroach is an insect. Cockroach is an insect and it belongs to Arthropoda phylum. Arthropoda phylum. In higher classes, you are going to know what is Arthropoda. Actually, Arthro means joints, poda means legs. So jointed legs containing organisms without backbone are called as insects. So cockroach, grasshopper, housefly, butterfly, any insect. These insects they are going to respire through the structures called spiracles and trachea. Spiracles and trachea. So here, just imagine if it is a grasshopper. Now see, it can able to respire through its sides of the body. It can able to respire. Why? Because at the side of their body, they contain holes called spiracles. I'll draw cockroach diagram here. It is cockroach. Right to the sides of the cockroach we can able to see the holes so these holes are called spiracles and these spiracles they open into the body of the cockroach through a tube line this tube line is called trachea windpipe like our trachea it also have trachea so from this spiracle the air enters in and here cockroach it don't have hemoglobin so the blood of cockroach is white in color due to lack of hemoglobin so that directly the blood the gas that inhaled gas with oxygen it directly enter into the blood of the cockroach it enters into blood of the cockroach and we are calling it as open circulatory system because blood vessels are absent in the cockroach so here through the trachea oxygen enters in and from the organs the carbon dioxide comes out so here respiration is done by the trachea that's why it is called as tracheal respiration and the respiration process in the insects is called as tracheal respiration remember tracheal respiration right and next come to snail sorry earthworm how do earthworm breathes earthworm it breathes through the skin it have hemoglobin and it has slime skin okay now moisture skin is there now through this skin oxygen and carbon dioxide they inter exchange the gaseous exchange takes place through the skin and it is called cutaneous respiration. This respiration is called as cutaneous respiration. Remember, respiration present in the earthworm. Actually, earthworm takes the air that is present in the soil particles. In between the soil particles, there are presence of what you call there is presence of air, and that air can be respired by the snail. Now come to respiration in plants. So how do plant respire? Plants also require energy. It also takes the oxygen. Plants can able to respire through the small holes present in the leaf, and we call them as stomata. We call them as stomata. So here stomata is a opening or a pore which is present in the leaf, and through it can able to show the gaseous exchange. Gaseous exchange takes place through the stomata, right? So these are present in the leaf. These are present in leaf, and as well as on the stem there are holes called lenticels. Lenticels can perform respiration. Even the plant also respire through the roots. So root hairs, they are present in the soil, and whatever the air that is present at the soil particle, in between the soil particle, that can be taken by the root hair. So these roots can able to respire by root hairs, right? Root hairs, they can take the air present in between the soil particles, like earthworm. It also takes the air present in between soil particles, and in this manner it is going to respire. And some roots, they come out of the ground. The roots come out of the ground, right? So these roots are called breathing roots. These roots are called breathing roots. In other words, we can say nematodes. These are called nematodes. By using nematodes, it is going to respire. We can see them in mangrove plant. Mangrove plant, their roots comes out of the soil, right? So in this manner, plant also show the respiration. Here plant also require the energy, so it have to take the oxygen, it has to send the carbon dioxide. Actually, when it is daytime, it takes carbon dioxide and gives oxygen in photosynthesis. Listen carefully. When it is night time, there is no light, so that's why it takes oxygen and gives carbon dioxide. Not only in the night time, in the daytime also it respires. It takes oxygen and gives carbon dioxide continuously. So only photosynthesis takes place during the presence of light. Means it takes carbon dioxide and gives oxygen only during presence of light. When there is no light, when it is dark night, then it show only respiration. There is a difference now. In photosynthesis, it takes carbon dioxide, gives oxygen. In respiration, it takes oxygen and gives carbon dioxide. Photosynthesis takes place only during daytime, presence of light. And respiration takes place even in presence of light, even in absence of light, continuously respiration will take place. Right? So this is about respiration in different organisms. I hope you understand this lesson. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. I am ready to clarify. Right? Thank you.